Kolkata, the capital of West Bengal, is the biggest city in eastern India. A major metropolis, Kolkata is fast expanding both outwards and upwards. Each day, the demand for more housing and other infrastructure projects is increasing. Bricks are an essential part of this real estate boom, and as a result, there are over 2,000 brick fields in West Bengal catering to this need. Though the brickfield owners and other middlemen involved in the trading of the bricks earn huge profits, the manpower that steamrolls the industry consists majorly of the most deprived landless laborers belonging to the lowest stratum of society. As early as October, the labor contractors provide advances to the very needy, starving families in the disaster-prone rural areas, which virtually turns them into bonded laborers. They are in the brick fields for the next 7 months. The first week of November brings hundreds of thousands of these extremely marginalized people from the impoverished regions of Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, and even the neighboring country of Bangladesh to West Bengal. Though the brick-making season lasts for only 7 months till the onset of the monsoons in June, the workers come with their entire families, including children and babies in arms. Thus, the children are deprived of any opportunity to attend regular school. Very often, the same children contribute to the family income by working at the brick fields even before the age of 8. Adolescent girls, besides taking care of their younger siblings, also carry bricks in order to augment the family income. They carry headloads of up to 10 bricks at a time, walking almost 15 to 20 kilometers a day. These girls are extremely vulnerable to sexual exploitation at the hands of the owners, managers, contractors, and their agents, while the family looks the other way because of the debt burden. Sensing the need and urgency of the situation, the Kolkata Meriwad Social Centre, then a part of the Loreto Day School Sialda, had in 2008 started 20 schools in the brickfield areas. This was an attempt to provide basic functional education to these children. The Kolkata Meriwad Social Centre has in 2015 expanded the purview of work to over 50 schools, attending to the educational and welfare needs to over 2,800 children in a competent, ethical, and effective manner. These brickfield schools function in the districts of Hooghly, Howrah, Birbhum, and the North and South 24 Parganas in the state of West Bengal. The KMWSC has created a model for delivering education and welfare to migrant brickfield children that is working well and is cost-effective despite a number of serious contextual challenges. Dedicated teachers selected from all the local communities help in running the classes for 3 hours every day, Monday through Friday, for 7 to 8 months of the brick-making season. Classes are generally held in open verandas, under the trees and in the shade of brick stacks. Every school is managed by at least 2 teachers. Every morning, before school starts, one of the teachers goes from door to door in the living area of the brick fields to bring the children to school. This ensures regular attendance of the children who are often inclined to miss classes if not followed up. And the parents are too busy eking out an existence to even notice. At the same time, the other teacher gets busy making arrangements to prepare the class for the students. Seating using mats or bricks is readied for three groups A, B and C according to their ages. The teaching learning materials are also displayed to make the ambience colorful and interesting. The curriculum taught in the open school is constantly being reviewed and improved. Children are imparted basic language skills in Hindi, Bengali, and English. With the help of flashcards, they are taught to identify alphabets and make simple words with them. Thus, a basic foundation for formal schooling is given. Children often know the numbers but cannot identify their written form, which they are taught in the school. Basic numeric skills such as addition and subtraction is also taught with the innovative use of straws, bricks, marbles, etc. Games are a useful tool which helps children learn numbers while having fun. This also adds to their cognitive development. Recitation effectively helps the children to express themselves, which adds to the joy of learning. The teachers try their best to incorporate co-curricular activities such as drawing, clay modeling, handicraft making, etc. Physical exercise and sports activities are also given importance for the all-round development of each child. Prizes for sporting events are usually plates, utensils and other household items that the family can use daily. Children coming to the Brickfield schools get a small daily snack which supplements their poor diet and also ensures regular attendance. An evaluation of the children's social and academic skills is done at the beginning and end of the brick-making season. Each child is provided an evaluation report which is useful for mainstreaming them in regular schools in their home states as they grow older and don't need to migrate with their parents every year. As an incentive for good performance, over 1300 school bags were distributed among the meritorious students to encourage and inspire them. As most of the Brickfield workforce hails from Nevada in Bihar, the Kolkata Meriwad Social Centre is currently in the process of mainstreaming around 400 children into government schools in the Nevada region. The KMWSC has also provided complete school kits to these children to enable them to pursue their studies. KMWSC staff visit Nevada to conduct community awareness programs about safe migration, importance and right to education and access to government schemes and benefits. With the support of Mission Kara, KMWSC hopes to mainstream 5,000 children over the next 5 years. All the Brickfield teachers are regularly trained and updated on the curriculum based on modern teaching methods. This helps them improvise and innovate and to make learning a fun experience for the children.
एक जो कोलकाता मेरीवाड सोशल सेंटर से जो ट्रेनिंग दिया जाता है उससे हमें बहुत सुविधा मिलती है और हम लोग चाहते हैं कि भविष्य में भी उसी तरह का ट्रेनिंग मिले जिससे कि बच्चे सीखने में अधिक माने अधिक मात्रा में ये लोग सीख सकते हैं। किंतु जब हम लोग एक्टिविटीज़ क्रियाकलाप के द्वारा इन लोगों को सिखाते हैं तो ये बहुत जल्दी कैप्चर कर लेते हैं और उसको फिर घर पे भी या और भी कोई आता है तो उनके सामने करके दिखाते हैं।
They are also given hands-on training on site to help them adapt to the local conditions and requirements. The Kolkata Mary Ward Social Centre is constantly advocating the cause of the migrant children of the brickfields at all levels, from the brickfield owners to the local government authorities, to ensure safe migration.
ये जो सबसे पहले तो ये जो संस्था यहाँ स्कूल बच्चे को चला रहे हैं बहुत बहुत इनको धन्यवाद बोलेंगे क्योंकि ये जो बच्चे हैं बहुत बहुत लो लेवल के बच्चे हैं बहुत अदर स्टेट से आए हुए हैं जिस तरह के टीचर लोग हैं यहाँ पे बहुत बहुत अच्छे से पढ़ा रहे हैं बच्चे लोग को टिफ़िन वगैरह जो है वो भी रोज़ रोज़ बहुत अच्छा से मिलता है लगभग अभी जो आपके ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से जितना सुविधा मिल रहा है बहुत बहुत अच्छा है अभी जो यहाँ पे स्कूल जहाँ पे हो रहा है क्लास वहाँ पे एक पेड़ के नीचे हो रहा है छाया वगैरह नहीं है तो यथासंभव हमसे जितना होगा शेड बने या जो भी हो जिस तरह का भी हमारे तरफ से मदद चाहिए हम देंगे जगह का थोड़ा बहुत रिक्वायरमेंट होगा वो भी प्रोवाइड करेंगे ताकि वहाँ शेड हो बच्चे लोग अच्छा से पढ़े बच्चे लोग को उन्नति हो
गिवन इट्स एक्सपीरियंस एंड एक्सपर्टीज द कोलकाता मेरी वार्ड सोशल सेंटर hopes to play the role of facilitator for launching a statewide or even nationwide initiative to find ways and means to promote the education, welfare and protection of these children. They also hope to be able to look into the well-being of their families.